Hallelujah.
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 We have a few beautiful passage in the book of Hebrews chapter 10. In Hebrews chapter 10, the Lord gives a beautiful passage. Verse 23, let us hold fast the confession of our hope without wavering. So, the faith in us, the things that are happening in our lives will make to waver in our faith. That's why in verse 24 it says, let us consider one another in order to stir up love and good works. So stirring up means what? Shaking up. We need to constantly shake up our faith. We need to constantly work on our faith. Very important. If God has to do, He does great things in our lives. The enemy will try to waver. What we need to do? Stir up. Wavering, the enemy side. From our side, we need to stir up constantly. That's why in verse 35, He says, do not lose the confidence the Lord has given to you. Continue to persevere. Problems will come. Problems will go. The one who has called you is faithful. Without wavering, stirring up yourself, stirring up the hope for which God has called you, you need to continuously move ahead in life. He says, if you go back, verse 38, the just will live by faith. But if anyone goes back, oh, it is too difficult for me. He says, my soul will not be happy with you. I have no pleasure in the one who goes back. Persevere. He says in verse 39, we are not among those who draw back, but for Dubai, we are those who believe to the saving of the soul. In a nutshell, the Lord says, perseverance in your faith, in your life, is that which will build up your life. Take care, your faith is not wavered. Problems will come. But the one who has called us is faithful. And the one who has called us is for a purpose. He has not called you for a joke. So move ahead. By moving with Him, by stirring up ourselves, we will find the purpose of God. Purpose of God is not just given to you in a plate. Problems, disturbance, we hold on to Him. And in perseverance, we move ahead. As we move ahead, the plan and the purpose of God is revealed to us one by one. We read in the book of Acts, those of the Bible, please take Acts of the Apostles, the last two chapters, where we find for 14 days, not one day, 2 days, 14 days, Paul, as not as a guest, as a prisoner, he is traveling in the boat. And there is storm, there is problem, there is no food except the wheat and the old bread. 14 days ago, the bread was baked and given. And suddenly they saw the seas troubled, and they are thrown into the sea, still worse, not knowing where we go. In your life also, are you tossed by the wind of various type of problems, various type of situation, still worse, you do not know where you go? What do? Are you disturbed? But you have something. There is someone who is alive in you. If you have to Catch him. Catch that presence. You will be able to handle. The psychologists will say, are the so many good books, how to be firm in life. All of them will say, you have to go on, tell yourself, no, no, I can overcome this. I can do this. You got to strengthen yourself. No. The Bible says, perseverance means not an intellectual support or intellectual encouragement or giving certain confidential phrase and repeating that. No. In the Bible for us, it is to be conscious of the presence of God and move ahead with the mission which he has given to us. That is called perseverance. Being conscious of the presence of God and moving with the mission he has given to each one of us. The man who is aware of the presence of God in him, the man who is conscious, my Lord is a faithful God. If my God allows me to go through a trials or something, he has a plan for that. My God will simply never allow me to be destroyed. You have to be conscious of the presence of God. And you would be conscious of the mission he has kept for you. It is through these two wonderful gifts you will persevere in your faith, in your vocation, in your life.